Before we start the video, let me give you a brief introduction about myself. I'm Chandresh Mahajan, who is founder and chief educator at Exergic, which is India's most trusted and comprehensive institute for online GATE preparation. I got an All India rank 37 from GATE Mechanical Engineering, and I am an ex-Indian Oil officer, having 6+ years of teaching experience as of now. To know more about our GATE courses, you can contact us on these details. Also, you can download Exergic GATE preparation app from Google Play Store. The link is available in the description of video. Hello, dear students. Welcome to Exergic. And this video is very important for all the aspirants of all the year, all the branches. So make sure you watch this video till the end. This can totally change your approach towards attempting questions in test series as well as in GATE exam. Before I tell you whatever I want to share with you, have a look at this particular question. This is a question from one of the tests of Exergic test series. Now, this is a very basic problem of mechanics. It is asked in mechanical engineering, but to be honest, it is something that any one of you can understand because we have already covered these basic mechanics in school days also, as well as in the first year of engineering. And this problem is specifically on law of conservation of energy, a law which all of us know about irrespective of our branches, right? But you know that this question was attempted by very few students who wrote that test. Many students wrote that test, out of which only 1/4 and 1/5 attempted this question. And in those students also, only 15% could solve it correctly. 85% solved this question incorrectly. It was an MCQ question. It has the options. It had the options. Still, only 1/5 of the students attempted it. And out of those, only 15%, 1/5, did it correctly. Rest 85% of those who attempted did it incorrectly. Now, is it a difficult question? No, it's a very easy, straightforward question. All you need to do is equate the potential energy stored within the rubber band to the kinetic energy of the pellet just before it leaves it. So half kx square is equal to half mv square. That's it. That's all you needed to do. Every data is given to you in the question other than x. What is the value of x? How much the rubber band has been stretched? Still, only very few students could solve it correctly. Why? And that discussion on why is going to be useful for each and every one of you. If you have been observing the kind of questions GATE is asking, these are the problems based upon real life situations. Many practical problems. Rather than just giving the values, problem will be a realistic problem where a real world situation will be there. Like in this question, there's a slingshot, a gulel, right? And you are throwing some pellet, some stone using that gulel. So a real life situation is explained. Now, what happens when such situations are explained in a question? When such situations are explained in a question, language becomes expanded. More words need to be used. If this question was simple, a mass and spring problem, you can summarize this question in just one or two statements. But here, there were many lines and statements involved. Even a diagram was involved in the question. And that resulted into only few students doing this correctly. And this is the learning from this question, that skill from this question that you can understand which toppers have. It is not true that concept-wise students don't know about law of conservation of energy. Many of you know about law of conservation of energy already. But still, were you able to solve a very basic question on that in the exam? Yes or no? That is going to decide your rank. So rank-wise, there is knowledge-wise, there is not very much difference in top 100 rank and top 200 rank and top 300 rank. You cannot say that someone who got rank in top 100 is way more conceptual than someone who got rank under 300.
Concept wise, they are almost at par, but how to apply that concept in those 3 hours is a skill. Merely having the knowledge and concept cannot guarantee a top 50 or top 100 rank. This is something that you need to understand. Merely running after concepts without working on your problem solving skills will not get you a good rank. Now, coming back to this question, why in this question many of the students could not solve it correctly? Because whenever they look at a question which is lengthy, because it's a real life problem, real life based problem, question will be lengthy, diagram will be involved, they just get scared from such questions. It's true. For majority of the aspirants, it is true. They see a question of one statement to a statement, they will think that it's an easy question. They will be ready to waste even 5-6 minutes on that question. But the moment they see a lengthy question, they will get scared from the question. They will think it's a difficult question. One diagram is also added, it's even more difficult. That's how majority of the aspirants think. They will find reasons to just skip the question and not do it at that time. Even if they are doing, they will keep doubting their approach. You need to understand firstly that stop judging the question at all. Stop judging it at all. What will you do by judging the question? If it is easy, difficult, you have to attempt it with your whole heart, with your whole mind, with your full concentration. Why do you want to judge a question? You have to understand the question and solve it. You don't have to judge it. You are not in a place to judge a question. You are in a place as an aspirant to solve a question, understand the question. So point number one, stop judging the question. Toppers don't judge the question. They understand it, they solve it, and then they move ahead. And if you think that judging a question, stop judging a question is difficult for you, maybe it's a habit in you since your childhood that you keep judging the question in the test and you don't try to understand it, you divert your concentration in attention in judging the question, then I'm telling you one more thing here, that please don't judge the question by the length of the question. If you think that lengthy question is difficult, shorter question is easier, don't do it. In many cases, it is the opposite. Questions which are one or two statements long, many of the aspirants cannot solve correctly. But many lengthy questions are easily doable. This is one of those examples which only handful of students could solve out of thousands of students. So it is important for you to understand this. Stop judging the question. If you are judging the question, if you have a bad habit of judging it and you cannot change it quickly, then at least stop judging the question by the length of the question. And third, and the most important point here, that the language of the question is given to help you understand the problem. It is your friend. The language of the question, the description of the question, all of them are your friend. They are trying to explain the problem to you. You have to use them for your own benefit. You do not have to get confused. You do not have to get trapped in the language of the question. It's a very famous example that I give while solving the examples in the video course. Whenever I explain any question to the students, I remind them the language of the question is just the clothing. For example, right now I am wearing a slightly different shirt. I continuously wear the same blue shirt. Right now it has almost the same color, but it has some stripes, some lines, right? Clothing has been changed, but the person is not changed. The person is still the same. Changing the clothing, the hairstyle does not change the question, just does not change the person, right? In a same way, whenever you get a question, the question is there to ask you a concept. The language of the question can be different. In this question, the concept is law of conservation of energy. It can be asked in hundreds of different languages. The same person or the same question can wear hundreds of different clothes. It does not change him as a person. Similarly, it does not change it as a question. Only the language is different. What aspirants do, that they get trapped in the language. They don't try to think what concept is it trying to ask. This question is not interested in rubber band. This question is not interested in slingshot. It is not interested in the pellet. It is interested in law of conservation of energy. You have to see through the language and reach at the core of the question. What is this question trying to ask? Law of conservation of energy. If you think calmly, you can very easily see this in the question. You are stretching, you are giving energy, and that energy is transferred to the pellet via rubber band. So you just have to equate the energy. Whole setup is just the clothing of the question. Forget about it. Just focus on the core of the question. What concept is the question trying to ask? Whenever you are solving the question, from now on, try to focus on the soul, on the body, on the core of the question, and not on the clothing of the question. What is the language, whether diagram is given or not? Obviously, you have to read the question carefully, go through the diagram carefully, but always trying to think, what concept is this question trying to ask? That will simplify the question for you. You will not get confused and you will not get trapped in the language of the question. You will directly reach to the core of the question. And in this manner, you can be a topper and avoid such kinds of mistakes that aspirants do. This question is just one example. I have hundreds of such examples and I keep sharing such examples in the video analysis, that this is something that you can learn from this question, etc. This was just one example which I thought I should share with everyone out there, so that you can understand that what skills are needed other than knowledge to enter into the top 50, top 100 ranks. I hope you learn something useful from this and start applying this from the next time you start writing any question, any test.